What on here do you have that changes or controls how much you're going up and down?
I have no idea. No, I'm just kidding.
So I brought some experiments that I want to show you to talk about the pressure change. Because you're going up in the atmosphere and the pressure gets way lower. I want to show you an experiment to talk about that, about the fact that the air gets thinner.
Okay.
This is a vacuum chamber. And then I'm just gonna, like, I'm not even gonna blow this balloon up. I'm just gonna tie it. Okay. So I'm gonna turn the vacuum pump on. That little balloon at the bottom is the one that I didn't blow up
that
at all.
You did nothing to.
Yeah, and it's starting to expand. But these ones already have so much gas
That's
in there.
That's so cool.
The reason I wanted to show you this is because the first thing I thought about when I saw these massive balloons is the fact that these will expand. They'll go from 8 feet in diameter to about 10 feet because they do the same thing as these balloons. So there's more drag on them. There's so many things that go on.
It'll look bigger, but the issue is if they start popping.
Yeah.
That's a real
Yeah, if they're insane. Just closer together and touching.
What happens in your blood?
Slightly different thing. But we have an experiment for that if you want to do that one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. Perfect.
Yes. I was curious when I heard you were going up how fast you're going and how high you're going, because that determines whether you would get decompression sickness. There's a syringe with some fluid in here. I'm gonna pull it back and you'll see what happens.
What fluid is it?
I'm gonna have you guess. Okay, here we go. So you can see it continuing to bubble. I'm just holding it here. It's continuing to bubble.
So it's like carbonated water.
Amazing.
Is that what it is?
Yes.
That's awesome.
That's exactly what it is. So you pull it back, it keeps bubbling from all over in the fluid, and then you let it go and it stops. So this is exactly what happens
to your blood.
More with divers is decompression sickness, because you go down and the more pressure you're under, the more you can get nitrogen dissolved into your blood. I mean, this is like a really quick and drastic pressure change. So if that happened to you,
that's bad.
That would be bad.
Yeah. This is 17 pounds of lift. So like if you feel this one, feel it.
They're so hard to pull.
It's amazing,
that
right?
That is incredible.
So basically, if I had 7 balloons, you'd be so good to
like
go.
7 or 8 balloons? That's so cool. So you're using helium, which is a great gas for flying with balloons, but hydrogen gives you a bit more lift because it's less dense.
Helium is much more difficult to come by, more costly.
I wanted to do a demonstration with you, and I wanted to show you why you're using helium
over
and
hydrogen.
Not hydrogen.
So we have some hand sanitizer wrapped around a stick.
Oh, that is going.
Test number one, helium. It's basically what we expected.
Was that one clap I heard over there?
Yeah. So now we are going to do the hydrogen test.
We did it.
So that's why you avoid hydrogen balloons.
Wow.
That is awesome.
Yeah, that is awesome. Thank you.
I wonder,